Hello guys, good afternoon, welcome to my channel. So today we are here with the FSSI initiatives and current affairs classes. So this is the class 31 of FSSI daily series, and till class 30 I have uploaded everything in my Telegram channel also. So if you need the PDF format, you can go there, and if you haven't watched the videos, then you can go to my playlists and watch the previous videos. And one more good thing guys, today my channel has reached 1000 subscribers. I would like to show you that. So as you can see on the screen, the subscribers has reached 1002. So this has just been done in 39 days. So that is the biggest part here. So I would like to congratulate all, and I would like to thank everyone for this huge support. So with that, now we are going to discuss two topics. So since I have covered almost all the topics that has been mentioned in the syllabus of FSSI Assistant, now I thought of taking some FAQs related to standards itself from FSSI website. So these questions are taken from my website itself. So if you, and I have simplified all the things because there were some quite complicated words there. So I thought of making it simplifying video for you all so that you can memorize it easily. And I also got one current affairs part. So a memorandum of understanding has been signed between FSSI and one more organization. So this becomes quite important because it was a recent news. So I thought of adding this current affairs snippet in this PPT. Okay. So now with that, let us start the class. So the first question is, who is responsible for implementation and enforcement of FSSA, or who is the regulatory authority under the Food Act of India? So FSSAI and the state food authorities are jointly responsible for implementation. So you might think, yes, FSSAI is the main body that regulates the FSSAI Act, but there is also one more body, that is a state food authority, which has derived from the FSSAI Act itself. So if the question is there, then the jointly both of them are responsible for this enforcement of the act must be the answer. Okay. How enforcement activities are done with respect to FBOs? So enforcement is primarily undertaken by all the food safety commissioners of state UT along with the designated officers and food safety officers. So remember the hierarchy, the commissioner comes first. So after commissioner, designated officer. After designated officer, food safety officer. So this is the hierarchy among these three. So like there are other posts above commissioner also, but among these three, this is the hierarchy. Okay, commissioner comes first, then designated officer, then food safety officer. Okay, so food safety officer must report to designated officer, and designated officer must report to commissioner. Does any liability rest with the FSO, that is food safety officer, and can enforcement action taken against the FSO for not fulfilling his role? The FSO shall be liable to a penalty which may extend up to 1 lakh if she is found to be guilty of an offense mentioned under this act. Provided that in the case of complaint made against the food safety officer is false, the complainant shall be punishable with a fine shall not be less than 50,000. Like the food safety officer is also punishable, but if there are any fake complaints against the food safety officer, then the person who has given the complaint will also be fined. So the remember the amount also, it is 50,000 for the person who gives fake message and 1 lakh rupees for food safety officer. Okay. So what is the improvement notice and who issues improvement notice? So there was a buzzing word called as improvement notice. So let us see what was that. So improvement notice is the notice issued by the designated officer if FBO fails to comply with the regulation. So just assume, so this is an FBO. So he goes to get license, but the designated officer, after looking the details, says that he is not complying with the rules and regulation of FSSA. So return notice called as improvement notice will be provided to the FBO so that he can improve whatever the mistakes or the whatever the lacking of the criteria given by the DO, that is the designated officer. So this is known as improvement notice. Okay. Under what circumstances can the DO suspend the license? If the food business operator fails to comply with an improvement notice, then his license may be suspended. So if he doesn't comply with the improvement notice, then also his license will be suspended. Or if there is any random checking by the food safety officers in different FBOs, and if they find any mistakes or the any findings that they are not following the criteria mentioned in the Food Safety Act, then also their license may be removed. Okay. Under what circumstances can the DO cancel the license? So this is suspend. Okay, there is a difference between suspend and cancel. Okay, So suspend is for temporary period. Okay, but the cancel or dismiss. So you might have heard the, for example, if there is any civil servant taking corruption, then there will be two words, that is suspend or dismiss. So suspend means for temporary period and dismiss means for permanent period. So in this terminology, cancel is used. Okay. And then an appeal can be filed against the improvement notice, suspension, cancellation of a license. Yes, this is possible. Any FPO aggrieved by an improvement notice may appeal to the state commissioner of food safety, whose decision shall be final. So please remember, it's not a CEO or any other person, but it is the state commissioner of food. So if a DO cancels or suspends the license, then we can appeal to the state food commissioner of food, state commissioner of food. So, and his decision will be final. So whatever the decision will be given by this person, then it will be the final thing. And the same can be challenged in the Food Safety Appellate Tribunal, High Court of the respective states. So the decision is final means there won't be any modifications in his decision. There won't be any changes given by the state commissioner of food. But the aggrieved person can also again go to High Court or Food Safety Appellate Tribunal. So Food Safety Appellate Tribunal will be present in some of the places. And it is formed as per the requirement of the situation. Okay, it, not everywhere and every time it will be present. So as per the requirement, it will be done. So if it is not present, then you can go to the normal conventional court like High Court. Then again to the Supreme Court. Okay, this is the process that takes place in the appellate. Okay, what is the time frame for making an appeal to the state commissioner of food safety? So 15 days from the date on which, remember this name, date. Okay. So 15 days, only 15 days is provided for appealing to the commissioner of food safety in the state against the designated officer ruling. Okay. What is a food recall and what is this purpose? So recall means action taken by the FPO to withdraw any food from market which is not complying section 28 of FSSA Act 2006. So recall means action taken by FPO to withdraw any food from the market. So I assume that a person is selling some kind of food and after some time he gets to know that it is not safe for people to eat. So then he withdraws the same kind of food from the market. Okay. Which license is required by a food business operator to run a food business in more than two states? So FB operating in more than two states has to get central license for its registered office, head office, and separate license for each unit depending upon the capacity turnover. So there will be specific terminologies or the terms that will be mentioned in the act, and according to that they should take. But mainly if they are operating in two states, then first central license must be taken, and then after that state license must be taken as per the requirement and also the turnover rate. Okay. How the complaints are addressed at the state level? Upon the receipt of complaint grievance, the designated officer may examine the complaint grievance, and if found the samples are required to be lifted or inspection of the premises is required, he may forward the same to the concerned food safety officer. Food safety officer may inspect the premises or may draw samples as per the merits of the case under intimation of designated officer. See, first the main person who comes into a role is the designated officer. So we'll examine the complainant or grievance, and if we found the samples are required to be inspected, then he will allot the food safety officer to inspect such places. Then the food safety officer goes and inspects the things. So this is how the procedure takes place. Is there any difference between ready to eat and ready to cook food products? Ready to eat food are pre-cleaned, pre-cooked and ready for consumption without prior preparation, and ready to cook includes all the ingredients, and see, the name itself tells you. So ready to eat means, so everything will be ready. Like for example, there are some noodles packets where if you pour hot water into it, then the noodles will get ready. Likewise, they're ready to eat. And ready to cook means ingredients will be ready, then you can cook for it. Okay. So these are the different sections that are which shows about penalty, but this is not important. Just for your knowledge, I have pasted this here. So as you can see, the penalty and the fine has been mentioned, and the persons covered are also mentioned. So everyone has been covered. Like if they do not follow the rules or the act, then they are fined. Okay. So this was the total FAQs. Now let us go to the current affairs part. So FSSAI inks MOU with Food Processing Ministry to support micro entrepreneurs in the sector. So as you can see, the news was from October 3, 2021. Okay. So this can be an important question because it is getting involved with other ministries also. Now let us see what has happened. Okay, FSSAI has signed an MOU with Food Processing Ministry to support micro level food entrepreneurship and farmer producing organization. So FSSAI has done an MOU with Ministry of Food Processing. Then the objective is to support micro level food entrepreneurs and FPOs, that is farmer producing organization. So if you don't know what is FPO, it is like farmers getting together themselves. It is nothing like a cooperative society where all the people come in together and they will put their money and they will select the leaders among them and they will start an organization. This is called as this FPO is majorly concerned with the farmers, not other people. Okay. MOU also aims to support self-help groups and producers cooperatives to improve the standard of the food business. So self-help groups, it also is also based on the same methodology, but different persons is present. That is that's the difference. Okay. As a part of Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, this step will help in making micro enterprises improve the quality of their food products and become competitive. So this there will be two areas of collaboration between FSSAI Ministry of Food Processing Industry. So first one is the food safety training and registration of micro entrepreneurs. Okay, so you need to, in this slide you need to remember with which ministry it has signed an MOU, then what is the purpose objective of this MOU. So MOU is, if someone is not knowing MOU, I'll also tell you this. So memorandum of understanding. So it's like two persons or the two organizations come together and they will share their views and thoughts regarding a common problem. So after this sharing of and speaking about these thoughts, then they will create an file or a paper signed by both of them that these things should happen in this sector. And these are the targets that we need to reach. So after this, they both of them sign and they will coordinate together and work together to reach the common objective. This is the meaning of MOU. Okay. So food handlers of micro level food processing units will be provided training and understanding on good hygiene. On successful completion of training, the food handler will be provided food safety supervisor certificate by FSSAI. So this is the advantage. So after a proper training, then this certificate will be provided. So if you see in any hotels or restaurants, if you see these kind of certificates certified by FSSAI, then you will have the confidence, okay, this hotel is clean and hygienic and it has been certified by FSSAI and also proper training has been provided. So it is safe to heat here. So this is the mentality of the people when they see such kind of certificates. So this is an advantageous position for the FBOs. Okay. So this was the current affairs classes, guys. So if you like the video, please like it and share it with your friends and subscribe to my channel. And if you have any doubts, you can ask in the comment section. So that's all for today, guys. Thank you.